Cause every time I breathe, I take you in, and my heart beats again. And baby, I can't help it, you keep me drowning in your love. And every time I try to rise above, I'm swept away by love. Baby, I can't help it, you keep me drowning in your love.
And we're back at 8:30 on this Monday morning. It's the 22nd day of October 2001. Of course, those are the Backstreet Boys, fresh from their concert to raise money for the victims of the tragedies on September 11th. The boys have other projects on their plate, and we're going to chat with them. We're going to work on the queue system a little bit also, all right? Anyway, I'm Matt Lauer, along with Ann Curry, who's filling in on NBC. Back in 1997, the Backstreet Boys exploded onto the music scene with a single called Quit Playing Games With My Heart.
Quit playing games with my heart, with my heart, my heart.
Since then, the group has sold more than 60 million albums, making them one of the most popular bands in recent history. They're now set to release a new compilation CD. It's called Backstreet Boys, The Hits, Chapter 1, and they spent part of their weekend raising money to help the victims of the attacks of September 11th. Nick, Howie, Brian, AJ, and Kevin, good morning. Good to have you back.
Good morning.
I watched your face as you saw that clip from 1997 of yourself singing, and you went like this. You don't feel that much older, do you?
Well, it's just been a lot of time has passed since then. I mean, it doesn't really seem like it in years, but just in our career and, you know, growing up and... We've experienced a lot. We move forward.
A lot of time has passed, but I can't remember another group that, after only 4 years in existence, came out with a greatest hits CD. I mean, that's a very quick time. Why now?
Well, actually, we've been together almost 9 years, but
4 years this, that we have all that you've been that popular.
This is our fourth album that we'll be coming out with. So, yeah, it's almost a decade that we've been together now, and four albums worth of material and. It marks the end of one part of our career and hopefully the beginning of a new.
Well, the end of what and the beginning of what? I mean, how would you like to see, if we come back here in a year and talk to all you guys, how would you like me to say you're different then than you are right now?
Just, I think artistically.
Musically.
We're going to try, I mean, we've, from the very first record to Black and Blue Now, pardon me, we've kind of grown vocally as a group, as well as individuals, and writing, producing, things have changed, and you know, for the next record, it's going to change even more. We're just trying to grow as a group, as a unit, and I mean, hopefully we'll be writing again for the next record, producing, stuff like that, just growth.
Last time you guys were here, four of you were here. AJ, you were not here, and they were here to talk about the fact that you had entered rehab for alcohol and depression. First of all, how you doing?
Doing great.
You feel well?
I'm tired this morning, but I'm doing great. I'm doing absolutely wonderful. I've got great support from the fellas. The fans have been just off the chain. They've been so supportive throughout the whole thing. My family, friends back home. It's been getting easier, you know, but the initial getting out and getting back on the road was really scary for me.
These guys had a decision to make, and I guess the whole group did, as to whether you guys talked about that. And we talked about this the last time you were here. You decided... more information was better, as opposed to letting the story leak out in dribs and in drabs. Did you approve of the way it was handled?
We sat, when I sat the guys down and, you know, told them all to their face, this is what I have to do. They were very supportive, very understanding. And we had talked about ideas about, well, let's just maybe say, you know, he broke his leg or he did this or that. And you know what? I'm glad that it happened the way it did, because we've always been honest with our fans and with the press and media, and it's much more beneficial for everybody that way. It doesn't come back around
And when he says he's okay, he's okay?
He is okay.
He's all right? Because I remember you guys were here just before the announcement performing, and we were all saying, he looked fine, everything looked great, and you guys seem normal, so everything's fine.
Yeah, we're proud of him. It's not, you know, when initially after he came out of rehab, you know, they suggest that you don't enter back into the same environment so soon. And for him to do that and to do it so well, we're very proud of him.
Been over 100 days.
It's been, what, 100 and...
It's 112 today.
112 days.
Good luck. Not good. Yep. Let's talk about this weekend. All right. First of all, I know you guys lost a friend who was on one of the planes that was hijacked. Mm-hmm. So the tragedy hits home, as it does for most Americans. How have you felt about what you've seen in this country since September 11th?
Seen
unity. People coming together. I mean, you see, especially here in New York, you've seen so many people that probably would never give each other the time of day coming together to help each other. And it's like, it seems like the respect level for people of any race, of any religion, of anything around the world right now just seems to be better. It just seems to be really, really good. Respect towards people is just, it's great.
It's good to see us artists as well putting in a show like we did last night in Washington and as well as the night before and with VH1. You know, the whole industry, you know, music-wise and even acting-wise are all coming together and trying to, you know, raise as much money as well.
You guys are huge stars. I want to talk about the show you just talked. But even though you're huge stars, when you get into a room with the likes of Keith Richards, Mick Jagger, Paul McCartney, Elton John, Billy Joel, Michael Jackson, Mariah Carey, I mean, what is that like for five young men?
We were the youngest, I think, there. And it was just an honor to be a part of it, to be on the stage and share the stage with all those great people.
Who freaks you out when you walk into the room and you look over and go, there's who?
I went over.
James Taylor.
James Taylor, yeah. I had to go up and introduce myself to James Taylor. And he was standing with his wife. And, I said, I don't want to bother you. I'm a big fan. You know, so. But it was cool. He's a big idol of mine.
I was kind of starstruck at meeting Paul McCartney, and I went over there like a little groupie. Like, hi, Paul, can I meet you? I tripped out. We were backstage and we were doing little spot interviews, and I couldn't take my head off the TV because The Who was performing. And I've never seen The Who in my life, and because I'm like 21, and you know, Kevin was like, you know, oh, I've seen this all before.
How about Jagger at 60 years old?
Yeah, you know, we were actually signing some of the stuff.
They sounded great. They all sounded great, and they performed incredibly. It was an honor to be there, not only in presence of the artists, but with all the firefighters and the policemen and their families. And it was just very emotional, very powerful, the entire evening. We were sitting, you know, when we weren't performing, we were sitting in the audience, and just the energy there was incredible.
And the focus wasn't on the artists; it was on the true heroes that were there, and that's the police and the fire people.
It should be. Guys, always good to have you here. Stay healthy, stay well, safe trip to Japan whenever you go.
Thank you.
And come
back
and see us real soon.
Thank you very much.
Okay. We're back. And by the way, the new album hits the stores tomorrow.